Good day, everyone, and a very warm welcome to all of you from IMT Center for Distance Learning. I'm Dr. Nidhi Mathur, Area Chair, Human Resources, and I will be anchoring this session along with my colleague, Ms. Shilpi Rhituparth. This session is divided into two parts. The first part is about your institute and the structure of the academic programs. The next part is about academic processes. This session is going to give you lots of information about the program, and we understand that it will trigger number of queries, but we request you to give a patient listening throughout this session and note your questions on a piece of paper. Once the presentation is over, we will reply to all the queries. You are also requested not to initiate any cross chats. So let us begin with knowing your institute. So I would like to congratulate you on your decision to pursue higher education at IMT Center for Distance Learning. Over three decades, we are seen as pioneer in distance education and a leader in management education. Our vision is to impart continuum of management education through distance mode to learners across the globe. And to achieve this vision, our mission is to be an academic community leveraging technology as a bridge to innovation and lifelong learning. The second mission that we pursue is to continuously evolve management competencies for enhanced employability and entrepreneurship, and to serve society through excellence and leadership in management education, research, and consultancy. During this pandemic, we are not able to invite you for the orientation session to your campus. So let us take a virtual tour of campus. I'm sure you have liked your campus, and very soon we will be hosting you to your campus. So these are the beautiful pictures of the different IMT campuses. You can see IMT Hyderabad, IMT Dubai, IMT Ghaziabad, and IMT Nagpur. The choice you make to further your academic endeavors here at IMT Center for Distance Learning can benefit you in many ways. It adapts to students' specific needs because of the design and delivery system. It is affordable, self-determined pace of learning within and stipulated program timelines. It is flexible and you do not need to take any career breaks. It is quite interactive and learner-centric. So let me first introduce to you our director, Professor Dr. S.R. Musanna. Dr. S.R. Musanna is PhD in the area of organizational behavior. He's a member on the boards of different business schools. He's a trainer to judicial academies and judges training and research institute, Lucknow. So let us now hear from Dr. S.R. Musanna.
At the very outset, I acknowledge all your presence. Each one of you deserve that for the reason that you assembled for this orientation program. IMT CDL is a portal which has got a brand name of its own and has a legacy of over 3 decades. These are turbulent times, extraordinary times, but we have been dealing with it in the most extraordinary way. We are one of the foremost campuses which are completely online, and we have kept pace with the development that has been taking place. My dear students, you have been to campuses where you did your graduation, and in that you had a distinct way and method of pursuing those academic qualifications, and the emphasis probably would have been there on how do I acquire knowledge, how do I preserve that knowledge. But when you chose this after graduation, the methods would completely change. How would it change is, the first and the foremost is that those knowledge that you have acquired, some of them have to be preserved, of course, but most of them you must challenge. We would like that you develop a sense of inquiry and the intensity of thinking is promoted. So that is what we lay emphasis on when you actually start studying at IMT CDL. We also would like that you develop a competence, expertise in whatever chosen areas that you have marked for yourself, and develop the capacity of mind. Capacity of mind, when I say, you must look in many different directions, and generativity of ideas must be at the core. You should ponder over a problem in different ways and try to solve them for the societal gains and advantages. Besides that competence and expertise and the generativity, we also focus that you build a skill set which is required to solve the problems of this complex world. Some of these problems are very, very complex. And once you develop that skill, you would probably be serving the society, you will be serving the nation and also the world at large. Not only the competence and attitude makes a full set to succeed in life, but you must also build a kind of habit. I can do a thing once or twice, but then go back into the same loop and go back to what my common method of working was. So I can walk for a day, I can have a morning walk for a 3-day spell or even a week. But I want that you must develop that habit that it becomes your preferred norm, a preferred method that you will do this for a longer period of time. Learning is primarily going to happen through online, and therefore our members of faculty have done a hard work and taken pain that the learning management system is in place and you fully utilize the resources that we have at our command here. And if you feel that anything else is required in order that learning and development happens faster and you fully utilize it, you can also make your suggestions to us. We will of course rise to that and provide you the same. I believe that all education is all round development of the personality. Knowledge is just one part of it, skill is another part of it, but it has to be looked into in a holistic way, and all your thinkings must concentrate. How do I solve the problems of this world? How do I solve the problems of my organization and my society in general? I wish that you become a great ambassador for IMT CDL, because wherever you go out, people will always ask you from which organization you come from. And if you conduct well, if you do well, there would be a corresponding stamp on IMT CDL. I wish all of you a very happily engaged time during the course of your study here, and God bless you. Thank you.
Thank you for your words of inspiration, sir. I'm sure your advice is going to help the students enhance their life skills. Now, our senior dean, Professor Dr. Ravindra Kumar, is going to address you. Professor Dr. Ravindra Kumar is PhD in history from the Center of Advanced Study, Aligarh Muslim University. He has authored several courses on social sciences and environmental studies. At the end of 2017, he superannuated from IGNU and set up consultancy advising universities, colleges, and other agencies on strategies for open and distance and digital learning with focus on access and equity.
Hello, learners. Welcome to the open and distance learning world. It is a mighty learner-friendly system, popularly known as ODL. It helps you learn anytime, anywhere. You can choose the place of learning, say the comfort of your home, or the leisure time at the office, or the place of work, or even during the vacation in the in-between time. The routine of physical presence at fixed hours in the classroom situation is not binding in ODL. Moreover, learning can also be done at a pace suiting your requirement. I repeat, learning can also be done at a pace suiting your requirement. One lesson at a time is no compulsion. One lesson at a time is no compulsion. Part of a lesson in the 15-minute free time or even a smaller section in 5-7 minutes is the best possible option, because the learning material has been specially designed. This learning material has been designed to serve your purpose. To serve your purpose. It is in your personal possession. We provide you with all the CDs, we provide you with all the digital formats, we also provide you with all the textual format of the learning material. Therefore, it is in your personal possession, in the digital and the print format. And the facility is that you can easily access it, you can quickly retrieve it, you can access it on your digital devices, sometimes on the device that is handheld, the usual smartphone or the mobile phone. Therefore, it is not difficult to carry it with you all the time, and that is a big facility. And because you are able to carry it all the time, it is possible for you to give it as many readings as you prefer, which does not happen in the classroom situation. The ODL system teaches you at a distance, physical distance. You will all appreciate. It teaches you at a distance, physical distance, unlike the face-to-face situation obtaining in the classroom. But this distance does not induce I repeat, it does not induce any kind of learning debility. It does not induce any kind of learning debility. Therefore, you should not be mistaken that because you are a distance learning student and you are not in the classroom situation, it will be difficult for you to do learning quickly and easily. It does not induce any kind of learning disability. On the other hand, ODL encourages self-learning and utilizes all the modern technology advances that gives you multimedia learning in multiple packages. This self-learning material eliminates the necessity of a teacher. This is a very important factor and feature of the ODL system. It eliminates the necessity of a teacher in the classroom mode. That is important. In fact, this system expands exponentially the role of the teacher. In the classroom situation, the role of the teacher is only delivering lectures and interacting with you in multiple different situations. But in the ODL system, the role of a teacher is very, very different. This role of a teacher is that of a guide who will handhold you throughout the course of your journey in the learning process, from the beginning till the end. End is the evaluation stage. For about 2 years, therefore, the teacher will be your guide who will be hand-holding you. The teacher in the ODL system is implanted very, very carefully into the learning package. So apart from this hand-holding, your learning package is also a kind of a teacher to you. Teacher is physically not present, but is innate to the textual self-learning material. That is an important aspect and feature of the open and distance learning system. This intrinsic teacher embedded in the multimedia learning package is a unique property of the ODL system, and it makes ODL a very learner-friendly system. This learner-friendly system is highly assistive system, and therefore it gives you wonderful dividends if you are able to join it and devote time adequately to the learning system that is provided to you. As I said, the teacher in the ODL performs multiple roles, that of a mentor, a counselor, an escort, a guide, a support in the unforeseen difficult situations, as also a pathfinder during the course of your learning journey of 2 years or so. The operational details of all this will be given to you by the two illustrious senior anchors who are conducting this program, Professor Nidhi Mathur and Ms. Shilpi Rhituparth. Therefore, in the sections that follow this introductory oration, you should be very, very attentive and receive all the possible details that are handed over to you by the two anchors. The two anchors will also help you gain the entire learning apparatus. I once again welcome you and wish all of you the best of time during your stay with IMT CDL. Thank you.
Thanks for orienting our students towards open and digital learning and clear the web of doubts about the different concepts in the ODL mode. Thank you, sir. Now let me invite our Dean Academics, Dr. Bharti Singh. Dr. Bharti Singh has a teaching experience of more than 2 decades in a number of premier institutes. She's authored a book on managerial economics and designed curriculum for various courses.
I welcome you all to an engaging and enriching journey with IMT CDL. IMT Center for Distance Learning is a part of the IMT group that has been imparting knowledge for more than 4 decades. Open and distance learning mode is an opportunity for learners like you who want to upskill and reskill along with your professional commitments. Creation of skill sets, as we know, has become more relevant in the current context of an uncertain and ambiguous world. I am sure the management programs of IMT CDL will help you achieve your goals. Let me briefly share the features that would make your journey with IMT CDL quite satisfying and engaging. First of all, our curriculum, it is designed in a manner that would help you understand the management concepts in context of the business world. There is a quality content that is provided to you. the self-learning material or the study material is prepared in a manner to give you a feel of a guide by the side. Learner's perspective has been kept in mind to create the SLM. Authors have put some serious thought to engage you through this study material. It has been designed to generate interest despite your pressing demands on your time. It stimulates your curiosity and relates knowledge to the real world situations. The content is presented in a logical manner and it is self-explanatory. We provide you guidance through this study material. There are certain suggestions that are given to you, and there is a reinforcement of learning through the study material when you go through the self-check exercises and activities. The learning sessions at IMT CDL, they give you an opportunity to interact with the distinguished faculty. You also take advantage of group learning when you join these learning sessions. We have two virtual platforms, the learning management system, that is the LMS, and the student information system, that is the SIS, that would be available to you anywhere, anytime during your journey. But we all know that despite all these support systems, the completion of the program is the responsibility of the distance learner. You have the advantage of doing this program at your own pace, at a place which you feel you can easily browse through the recorded sessions, or you can go through the study material, or you can go through the videos and the like. But the evaluation part has to be undertaken by you in a time-bound manner. My advice to all of you is, please ensure to complete all your assignments and your end-term examinations in which you have to take again a platform to register and book your examinations as per the flexibility given to you. To complete all assessments is the hallmark for a successful completion of the program by the distance learner, despite being the advantage of taking it at your own pace. I wish you all the best for your journey with IMT CDL. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am, for enlightening our students. So it is the time for you to meet your faculty. Myself, Dr. Nidhi Mathur, I'm Area Chair, Human Resource Management. I have more than 15 years of experience in academics in the area of organizational behavior and public administration. Dr. Preeti Sharma, she's Area Chair, Finance. She's authored a book on an insight into mergers and acquisitions. She has several research papers in various national and international conferences and journals. Dr. Vivek Singh Tomar, Area Chair Marketing. He has around 20 years of professional experience, 3 years in industry, and 17 years of teaching full-time and part-time MBA students. He has good number of research papers and case studies. Dr. Preeti Sirohi, she's Assistant Professor in Business Analytics. She has more than 14 years of experience in corporate and academia. She has presented several research papers in the national and international conferences. Dr. Manoj Kumar Srivastava, he's Associate Professor in the area of Operations and Supply Chain Management. He's done his PhD from BHU, and he has more than 12 years of experience in academics and industry. So let us now begin with the program structure. As you are aware that the program structure has foundation courses, which is applicable to all the programs. There are three foundation courses: basics of accounting, basics of communication, and basics of management. These courses are non-credit courses, that is, marks obtained in these courses are not counted in the final grading, but it is mandatory to clear the foundation courses to become eligible for the diploma. Now, we will first discuss about 24 months PGDM, Postgraduate Diploma in Management. As I have already told to you that all the programs are going to have three foundation courses for PGDM 24 months. In semester one, you have 5 core courses, semester two, 5 core courses, semester three, again 5 courses. In semester four, you have 5 electives and a project. These are the course titles that you will be reading in your PGDM, Postgraduate Diploma in Management. So you can see in semester one, you have Principles of Economics, Management Accounting, Marketing Management, Business Statistics, and Managerial Communication. In semester two, you have Financial Management, Business Environment, Organizational Behavior, Operations and Supply Chain Management, and Introduction to Information Systems. In semester three, Legal and Regulatory Environment of Business, Strategic Management, Managing New Ventures, Human Resource Management, and Ethics and Corporate Governance. Then in semester four, you have to choose 5 electives and 1 research project. These are the list of elective courses. So you may opt from any of the following specialization area. Any 5 courses are to be selected. So here is the list for you. In human resources and operations. Then in finance and marketing. And in business analytics. We will talk about Postgraduate Diploma in Management Executive 15 months program. So here the foundation courses remains the same. In semester one, you have to reach 6 core courses. In semester two, 3 core courses and 4 elective. You also have to take 1 project term. Now in semester one, you will be reading these course titles: Principles of Economics, Management Accounting, Marketing Management, Business Statistics, Managerial Communication, and Strategic Management. In semester two, you will have Financial Management, Organizational Behavior, Operations and Supply Chain Management. And you have to choose 4 electives. Then there will be a project term for 3 months. Here is the list of electives for you. You have to choose any 4 courses out of this list. So the specialization is in human resources, in operations, in finance, in marketing, and in business analytics. Then we will talk about Postgraduate Certificate in Management, which is 13 months program. So here, foundation courses remains the same. In semester one, you have 5 core courses. Semester two, 5 core courses. And semester three, there will be a comprehensive viva voce. Here is the list of course title that you will be reading in your semester one and semester two. And then there is a comprehensive viva in semester three. Now I would request my colleague, Ms. Shilpi, to orient you towards the academic processes. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Nidhi. A very good afternoon, my dear students. This is Shilpi Rhituparth, and I look after the student support function at IMT CDL. I am going to take you to the next part of today's orientation session, where we will talk about the key interfaces you're going to use during the program. We will discuss what are the various assessment criteria. We'll also talk about how you're going to access your learning management system. We'll talk about how you will attend your online learning sessions, student support functions, and so on. So I'll start with my presentation now. So as Dr. Nidhi has already explained to you the program structure and what subjects you're going to study in a particular semester, we'll discuss what online learning sessions are. So as you have various courses in a semester, for each course, you're going to have online learning sessions. Schedule for these sessions would be uploaded in your learning management system or Edugeni account. So to begin with, so the first thing is that we have the online learning session schedule, which would be uploaded in your learning management system account. OLS schedule is a kind of timetable where you know on which particular date, at what time you have class scheduled for which subject. Okay, so this will already be uploaded in your LMS account. You're advised to refer to it on a weekly basis to monitor in case if there is a change. Otherwise, as per the schedule, the classes will be uploaded in your Microsoft Teams account. You can log in and join. So the platform which we are going to use to conduct these online learning sessions is Microsoft Teams. Okay. Now, one important thing that Dr. Nidhi has also explained in during her presentation, and I would also like to reiterate, that is, you have got in your semester one, you've got three foundation courses. Okay. Now, for these foundation courses, there are no online learning sessions. These courses are non-credit courses and have to be studied in self-learning mode. Okay. So there are pre-recorded lectures and the entire content which is already available in your learning management system. So the students who are enrolled for 2 years program, they have 5 core courses, and the students enrolled for the 15 months executive program, they have got 6 core courses. So please note that the classes or the OLS sessions will only be conducted for these core courses. There are no online learning sessions for foundation courses. So during the as we move forward, I will let you know, I will make you understand that from where you are going to access this OLS schedule and how will you understand it. Okay. Next very important part that I am coming on to, that is assessments. Okay. So as we know, during our schools also, or whenever we learn or study something, it's important that I get assessed on it to know my own progress, that whatever I have learned, has it actually gone into our system or not. So assessments, there are regular basis they will be conducted, and there are certain components of these assessments, okay, where we will evaluate you. So for each course, okay, when I'm saying course, it is the subject, I'm talking about the subject actually. So for each subject or course, there are going to be assignments and comprehensive examinations. Okay. Now, when we talk about the foundation courses, I should make it clear here that in foundation courses, which are 3 in number, you only have assignments. There is no examination. Okay. However, if I talk about the core courses, you have both the things, assignments as well as comprehensive examinations to attempt. Okay, so each core course has 2 assignments. Each carries a weightage of 15%. I would request you all to be a little attentive on this slide. This is very, very important. Otherwise, you will always be confused that how much do I need to score to clear a subject. So please understand that for each core course, you have got 2 assignments which carries a weightage of 15% each. And so total weightage for assignment is 30%. And then there is a comprehensive examination which carries a weightage of 70%. Okay, so total 100. Now, attempting both the sets of assignments is mandatory to clear the course. It cannot be like that you have attempted assignment 1 and missed assignment 2. That is not allowed. You need to attempt, right, both the assignments. There is no minimum passing criteria in assignment. So out of 15, whatever you score in assignment, it's okay. We will not say you passed in it or you are not passed in it. Okay. You have to attempt it. Now the other thing, which is the comprehensive examination, which carries a weightage of 70%, you have to score minimum 25 out of 70. Okay. And your collective score, which is examination and assignment, must be 40 to be declared pass in a subject. I hope it is clear to you. As I said earlier also, it's an important slide. So please be very, very careful in understanding, right? So two assignments for every subject, a comprehensive examination, no minimum passing criteria and assignments. However, it is mandatory to attempt them. Comprehensive examination, you need to score minimum 25 marks out of 70, and your collective score should be 40% to be declared pass in a particular subject. Okay. Moving on. So we were talking about OLS, right? So why it is important to attend online learning sessions, okay? Let me tell you one thing, right? We were discussing assessments also, that they are important, and we understand the fact that you are a working professional. So we have given enough flexibility to these students to learn in their own pace, okay? So there is no attendance. I mean, it is not mandatory to attend the sessions. However, you're always advised to be regular for your OLS sessions, because with the regular attendance, students gain academic, personal and professional benefits, right? When you regularly attend the live sessions, you have better opportunity of learning and doubt clearance. When you have the faculty, so whenever there's a doubt, you can ask, okay? And it is not always that I have a doubt and I want to ask. Many a times we learn from, you know, when others ask questions. So that is also there. So learning is increased because of peer-to-peer interactions, okay? And you're always better prepared for the assessments, okay? So you're always advised not to miss out the online learning sessions. However, in case because of some emergency or some other work commitment, you are not able to attend, then the recorded lectures are always available, which you must refer to. Moving on, we've spoken about two components of assessment so far. One was your assignment and another one was your comprehensive examination. Now, the next thing, which is projects. So you have to understand that assignment and examinations will happen in each semester. However, the project has to be submitted only once during the program, towards the end of the program. Okay. So this project is applicable to 2 years PGDM students and 15 months PGDM executive students. For 13 months program, there is no project work. Yes, there is a comprehensive viva which you need to take, right? So project is actually that you have whatever you have learned, whatever concepts you have learned, a real life implementation, that when you will apply these concepts in the real life situation or scenarios, how well you will be able to apply these concepts, right? So that is to check that ability of yours is the this particular component is meant for, okay? So this is a two-step process actually. Step one is the preparation of project synopsis, okay? Project synopsis is a kind of a proposal document that I want to give it to the faculty, that this is the problem that I have taken up. This is the real life problem that I have taken up, and I am going to apply the concepts on this particular topic. So project synopsis is that proposal document which has to be submitted from your student portal, okay? And this is an online form, so predefined pro forma is given. You just have to fill in the required information. Faculty will evaluate it. They're either going to approve it or reject it, okay? So once it is approved, you have to understand that the project report or the project work will be, you will work on only that project for which the synopsis is approved by the faculty. In case if the synopsis is rejected, you have to again submit the synopsis for the approval, okay? Once the synopsis is approved, then you'll have to do the detailed project work and make a proper detailed report which has to be uploaded on your student portal. So this particular thing comes towards the later stages of your program. There are complete guidelines, timelines, everything is uploaded or will be uploaded in your student portal. So you may refer to it, and in case if you have any doubts, so the support team is there, the faculties are there, you can always reach out to us. So moving on, Now, many a times you will find me saying very, very important slide, because these are important things for you to understand. So again, I'm saying that you are on an important slide. There are certain student interfaces, okay, which you would keep using during the program, okay? So the first interface that we have is Microsoft Teams. This is a platform. This is an interface through which you will be attending your online learning sessions, which will be conducted every week. Okay, so the way many of you are attending it from your own Microsoft Teams account, in the similar manner, you will be attending your OLS sessions also. Okay, then we have learning management system, which we call Edugenie. What is the purpose of giving it the name Edugenie? Edugenie is that your wish, my command. So if I want to refer to the recorded lectures, if I want to refer to the PPTs, which the faculty has shared during the class, or some additional reference material, which was shared by the faculty during the class or otherwise. So everything is uploaded in your learning management system. As per your own convenience, you can refer to it, you can go through it, and whatever are your doubts and queries, you can ask the faculty in the next class. Okay, so this is the next interface. Then we have Student Information System, or SIS. This is a transactional interface. So wherever you have to pay the next semester academic fee, you want to change your communication address, you want to you want to check your examination records, right? You want to download your mark sheets towards the once you complete an year or so, right? So all those things are available in your student information system. Like you have to submit a project synopsis, so that option will also be there in your student information system portal. And then we have student support services. So here at IMT CDL, we understand that you all are working professional, and this support function becomes much, much more important and vital when students and the institute's face-to-face interaction is less, okay? So we have a robust team, we have a robust system, and a team, dedicated team to help you out whenever you are stuck up into something, right? So I'll demonstrate you all these interfaces one by one so that it is more clear to you. To start with, we have Microsoft Teams. So, see, pre-COVID, people hardly knew what is Microsoft Teams, but now all kind of sessions, like you talk about all kind of online sessions, mostly it is being used by schools, colleges, higher, and during, you know, for higher education institute, everywhere. So you need to have Microsoft Teams application installed on your system or a mobile, wherever, like whatever you are using. Once you open it, you will be prompted to enter the, this is the kind of screen you get, okay? And you have to enter the login ID. Now, please understand that many a time students get confused that it is asking for Microsoft account, okay? So you all must have received a Microsoft Teams ID from IMT CDL, okay? This is the regular pattern for this is your 8-digit application form number @imtcdl.ac.in. So please search your mailbox. You must have received this kind of ID along with the password. So that is what you need to keep safely. Take a note of it. Keep it at a place. You know, you should have it in your system saved so that you don't have to search for it whenever there's a class. Okay, so this is the ID that you will be using to log into your Microsoft Teams account. So Microsoft ID is not your email ID. Sometimes people enter their Gmail IDs or their Outlook IDs. Please don't use that. You have to use the ID provided to you by IMT CDL. I hope this is clear to you. Now, once you log in to Microsoft Teams, you can see something like calendar over here. Okay, you need to just click on it, and then you will find all the classes mapped over here. Please note, there is no separate class link which will be shared with you, okay? So don't keep waiting that I was told a class link will come. You should not wait. You should just log into Microsoft Teams, go to the calendar. All your classes would be mapped 24 hours prior to the scheduled timing, okay? You need to just click on that session and click on join, and you will be logged into the class. I hope this part is clear to you, that to attend OLS sessions, first thing is referring to your OLS schedule, which I will tell you, okay? The second step is to log into your Microsoft Teams account, go to the calendar and look for that particular class and click on join, okay? One important thing which I would like to tell you, over here you can see the mode of the calendar coming in as work week, okay? Make sure that this is chosen as week, because when you choose work week, it shows you only Monday to Friday. However, if you choose week, it will show you Saturday, Sunday also, okay? So you should check for that. I will just show you how will you log in to your Microsoft Teams account, okay? So I have to log into my Microsoft Teams account. So I have already used like an ID. Otherwise, you can choose what you can say, because there are multiple accounts, so it is prompting me. So you will get this kind of login screen, okay, where I am supposed to enter the login credentials. So what I was telling you, that you have received a Microsoft Teams ID from IMT CDL. So you need to enter that. You will click on next. You'll be prompted to enter the password in the same mail where the ID is being shared. You have your password as well. Please don't try changing this password. This is a system generated password. And once you forget or regenerate, it takes 2 working days to get it regenerated, okay? So please take a note of it. Don't share it with anybody, but keep it safely with you. So I am saying sign in. Okay, so see, this is the interface. This is what I was showing you in the presentation also. You have got this. There is an option of calendar. I'll go to this option. I'll choose this option, calendar. The important thing that I was talking about was work week. This is the mode of calendar. This is the view of calendar. So I need to change it to week, right? So now you can see, I can see all the 7 days of the week appearing in here, including Saturday and Sunday, right? So I'll go back, because I'll look for the classes which has already happened. Wait. Yeah, so for this login, maybe the classes were scheduled in the month of October. So you can see in the similar manner, you will find the links over here, okay, and a join button. Join button will be there for all the upcoming classes, okay? You just need to click and join. Nothing else needs to be done, okay? So I hope this part is clear to you. Back to the next interface, which is Learning Management System or Edugenie. Anything which is related to your learning process. Maybe it is your ebooks, maybe it is your assignments, maybe it is the additional learning material or the PPTs which is being used by the faculty during the class, or the recorded lectures, everything you will find over here. So to log into your LMS portal as well, you would need Microsoft Teams credentials, okay? Which I have just shown you that you would have received it in your registered mail ID, which is like your 8-digit application form number followed by @imtcdl.ac.in. Okay. In the same email, we've also shared the URL to log into your LMS account. Okay. So I'll demonstrate you this part also. But once you come to LMS, you will be prompted to enter your login ID password, and there are two options coming in. You are advised to use sign in with IMT CDL ID. Once you click on it, you have to enter the login ID and password, which I have already told you that the Microsoft Teams credentials. And after logging in, you will find these kind of boxes for each course. These are the foundation courses. Similarly, for core courses, you will find the details. Once you click on a particular course, you will find the PPTs, some handouts, some online assignments. Basically, these are different tabs, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on, numbered tabs. So you can click on any of them and browse that whatever is uploaded, whatever faculty feels should be given as the learner resource to the student, that is available over here. Okay. So you can see the recorded lectures. It is on tab number 2 and so on. Now, these are your core, these are your foundation courses, basics of management, basics of communication, and basics of accounting, right? Then you have your core courses also uploaded. Then you can see if I click on any of the core course, the recorded sessions are available. So one good advantage over here is not only the recorded sessions for you, but for previous sessions also the recordings are available. So you may refer to them as well, okay? You can see the ebook is available, assignments are over here. The PPTs which are being taken by the faculty, which were being used by the faculty, or some additional resources, like some chart is uploaded here and so on. So all that you will find in your LMS. I'll show you this also. So as I said that the URL will be available. URL is being shared with you in the same email where we have sent Microsoft Teams credentials to you. Okay. URL is slm.imtcdl.ac.in/Moodle. This is the URL. You click on login. You are getting this, these two options. This is what I have shown you. I was showing you it over here. Second. Yeah, this is what I was showing you, that you'll get two options. So see, you're getting two options here. You will choose sign in with IMT CDL ID, right? So it is already logged in actually, because Microsoft Teams is already logged in. So it is coming in. I'll log out from here. I go back to login. I say sign in with IMT CDL ID. I think it is again logging in. Okay. Let's try once again. Otherwise, I'll tell you another way out. Okay, leave it like this. I will open the browser window in the incognito mode. Okay. This is an important thing to understand, because many a times it is observed that you're using the same laptop which is being issued to you by your office, and sometimes there is some particular ID already configured on it. Okay. So whenever that is a situation, please open the browser window in the incognito mode and then try logging in. I'm entering the Microsoft Teams ID. I'll say next. And if you see, I'm entering the password now. And I'll click on sign in. See, you will get the same thing that I was talking about. Okay. So you have these core courses, basics of management, basics of communication, basics of accounting, and you've got these core courses. So these three were like the ones which begin with the word basics. They are your foundation courses, and the other for which you have received the study material, they are your core courses. So I click on any of the core course. Let's say I click on managerial communication. You can see different tabs, numbered tabs coming in. On number one, you have ebook, you have it is in two parts, right? And then you have the PPTs uploaded, you have assignments. See this, right now there is no assignment applicable or active for the student, so it is coming as that it is already done on 8th of March. But otherwise, you will find these links for assignments over here. Semester 1 assignments has to be attempted from your LMS account. Then you have your recorded lectures. You can keep browsing, okay? So all the things are available over here. Let's look at some other course as well. One of the foundation course, let's say we pick basics of communication. I click on it. So the as discussed that these foundation courses has to be studied in self-learning mode. So you can see the PowerPoint presentation, the handouts, okay, for these courses are available here. This is the actual learning material for this particular foundation course, okay? So you are supposed to read it. You are advised to go through the PPTs. Then I come to tab number 2. You can see the recordings are available. There are three in three parts, okay? So class 1, class 2, class 3, the three recorded lectures available which you may refer to. And over here you will find the link to attempt the foundation course, right? So moving on, this was related to your LMS. Let's come back to our presentation. This is what we have seen. We've logged in with IMT CDL ID. We have seen foundation courses as well as core courses, the learner resources available and link for attempting the assignments, recorded lectures. All this you will find in your LMS account. I hope this part is also clear to you. In case if you still have doubts, any queries, it is very, very important that you don't hesitate in asking. Please reach out to us. There are various channels, okay? So we'll discuss about these things, that how can you reach out to us towards the later stage. Right now, we're moving to the next interface, which is the student information system, okay? So as I was talking about, this is an interface through which you will do a lot of transactional stuff, okay? So please understand that to log into this interface, you need to have your roll number or enrollment number, which is a 10-digit alphanumeric number. It is generated after we have received and verified all your required documents. Okay, whatever documents were asked at the time of admission, once you've submitted it and they've been verified, the authenticity is checked, then your enrollment number is generated. So to log into this portal, it is mandatory that you have your enrollment number. Okay. So how will you access it? You'll go to IMT CDL website, imtcdl.ac.in. Then you will go to student information. You'll go to student zone, right? And over here you will find an option, student information system. You need to click on it. You'll be prompted to enter login ID and password. But as a first time user, you have to, you're supposed to click on this button, new user. As a first-time user, you have to register yourself on SIS, okay? Student Information System. So once you click on this new user, you will see a small registration form is being opened, okay? It is opened here. You can see the roll number or the enrollment number, which I have just told you that your 10-digit alphanumeric number, which you would receive. Many of you would have even received, right? So your name, date of birth, some basic details, okay? Then you have to, the password for this account is user defined. So whatever password you want to keep, you will be entering over here. And you will click on the button register. Once you are registered, you will receive an email on your registered email ID where a verification link would be given. You need to click on that to activate your account, okay? So after successful registration, a confirmation email is sent to your registered email ID. Login ID is your enrollment number. I'll repeat, it's a 10-digit alphanumeric number, okay? And password is user-defined, the one which you have mentioned over here at the time of registration. Through SIS, you can refer to the academic calendar. You can access student handbook. You can do your exams booking. In your later semesters, some assignments will also be there, not in semester one. You can refer to your academic records, mark sheets, and other financial transactions, okay? So you should refer to SIS for all critical announcements, okay? So you see, this is the interface that we have for student information system, where on the top, your on the student homepage, you have your details, personal details coming in, okay? Where your communication address, email address, contact number, name. So you're advised to check all these things, okay, in the beginning, so that in case if there is a change, some you feel there's some change in email ID or it is incorrect, or your mailing address, there's something missing. So you should check out and verify these details over here. Now, what kind of options are available? For change of address, click here. So if you have your communication address changed, you can update it from here. Mobile number changed or any such updation, okay? You want to download your semester fee receipts. You want to print your identity card. You have academic calendar, which would have all the timelines. Student handbook, okay? So all these important things are there. There are few links which are not relevant to you, so you can ignore them right now. You will be using it at later stages. Your marks records, so assignments for semester one, it is not on SIS, so you can ignore this part. Then you have student care services. I'll discuss about this tab in detail. You have frequently asked questions, you have examination timelines, your mark sheets and other stuff. And this section is for projects, okay? So the project guidelines. So this comes at the, you don't need to go through it right now. This is relevant when you will be towards your final semester, okay? So I will demonstrate you on this as well before we move on to the next interface, okay? So what I need to do to access SIS? Can anyone tell me? You can type in the chat box. You should go to the registered, you should go to the IMT CDL website, which is imtcdl.ac.in. And over here, you should go to the option student zone and then select student information system, right? What I was telling you, as a first time user, you should click on this option, new user. Where a registration form opens, you please enter your roll number or enrollment number, which is 10-digit alphanumeric number, your name, date of birth, your email address, mobile number, the password that you want to keep, and then repeat the same, enter the same password again and click on register. But if you are already registered, I mean, if you've done the registration process, then you will click on login. And to login, you will enter your roll number. So I'm taking one saved roll number. Then enter the password. You can see this. This was the student homepage. So you, whatever details are coming in here, you can check and update. Then what you have? You have for change of address, click here. So in case if there's a change, click and update it, okay? You have student handbook. You all are advised to go through it properly. This will be uploaded in your account. It will be available for your session. All key guidelines, academic policies, rules, regulations are available here. You must go through it, okay? In case you have any doubts, please reach out to us. You have the academic calendar, which is as of now not uploaded for you, but This will be done in a week's time, where you will find it critical timelines that you have to refer to, that when you will have your assignments, when you have your examinations, right? You can print your iCard from here. You can track your book dispatch. You can download your semester fee receipt. One more important thing, which we will certainly discuss during the presentation also. These are the guidelines for online behavior. So we will talk about them. You have FAQs. So all these things are the one which you can explore, okay? Now, the next is this section, examination and mark section, where you will do your exam registration, booking, and the result declaration, your statement of marks, all these things. Download e-mark sheet. This is the project section, and this is the assignment section, where you don't have to do anything as of now. One important thing over here is your student care system. So that is what I was saying, that we understand that you are working professionals, you are short of time and all that, but yes, when you are a working professional, you are more clear, more particular, and you know what is important, what is not, and you are able to prioritize things in a better manner. So being a working professional should not be used ever. I'm sorry, should never be treated as an excuse that, ma'am, we don't get time because you're working professional. Rather, it should be your strength that you are much, much more organized and clear with your priorities because you are a working professional. Okay. So whenever you have any doubt and query, we are there to help you. There's a dedicated team. Okay. So there are different ways and means. One of them is raising a query from your student portal. Okay. So when you want to raise a query, just go to log into your SIS. You choose if it is related to fee payment, if it is related to assignment. So the category in which you want to raise the query, maybe a study material and so on. Type in your query over here. Enter your mobile number and submit it. Once you submit, within 48 working hours, you will get the response. This is the maximum time limit that I'm telling you. Mostly, if the query is raised within the working hours, you get the response. Okay. So this was your student care services portal. This is what we were discussing here also. See. All this is what we were discussing, right? Student care services, the project section, examination section, right? So one I have shown you that student care services is here. You can raise a query. Now the other ways and means to reach out to the support team, okay? The first is raising a query. Second, calling us on our toll-free number, which is 1-800-102-1063, and pressing option number 2 to reach out to the support team. Or you can email your queries to support@imtcdl.ac.in. Then we have student care services. The portal that I have just raising a query from your SIS account. So from here, you will be raising your query. This is the toll-free number which I have just shared. It is working on all the 7 days from 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. So call us on 1-800-102-1063 and press option number 2. Or you can send us an email on support@imtcdl.ac.in. But please don't assume things. Don't rely on what your friends are sharing with you. Reach out to us, right? Take clarity, seek clarification and guidance as and when required, right? Now, for you, the online learning sessions would start from 27th of March 2022. So the next weekend is Holi, and after that you will be starting with your classes from 27th March. Okay. So as I told you that after logging into Microsoft Teams, you have to select the scheduled meeting from the calendar to join the session, and there's no separate class link which will be sent to you. Okay. One thing which I have not shown you here is that how will you access your learning schedule. So you will find once you log into your LMS account, there is something called site announcements. Okay. Under the site announcements, you will find the class schedule. So the schedule applicable to you would be of semester one. Right now it is not uploaded, will be done in a week's time. You click on that schedule and a file will open, a PDF file, check it. Okay, so on Sunday, this is the time, this is the time, this is the date, I have a class, this is the faculty. Now, according to the schedule, the class will be mapped in your Microsoft Teams account, refer to it, just click on join and attend the session. Okay, so this was what we had related to your OLS sessions. Okay. Now, it is not that it is vital or something, but as a student, you are expected to demonstrate certain behavior. Gone were the days like pre-COVID, of course, we were more into the face-to-face interactions and the conventional, which has been the conventional method of learning, okay? That you have a teacher, there's a class, there are other students sitting with you, and when there's a student who keeps disturbing the entire class, teacher keeps saying, you know, sit quietly, don't do this, don't do that. But when you are attending the sessions in online mode, there is certain behavior expected from you, certain things that you need to demonstrate in your behavior while attending the online sessions. So we call them netiquettes, and these are the guidelines for attending online sessions. So you must be on time for all online sessions. Try login at least 5 minutes before the scheduled start of the session. Sit at good location, ensuring no movement of other people. Properly lighted and clean background. Keep your video and audio switched off at all the times unless specifically allowed by the session presenter. In case of verbal interaction during online sessions, ensure that there's no background noise, disturbance. You must use formal, professional and courteous language. Use of any derogatory language towards any gender, religion, region, caste, culture, etc. is strictly prohibited. Use of any offensive, abusive or disrespectful language towards faculty or fellow participants is strictly prohibited. These are general things. It is not only that when you are learning online, when you are attending sessions, otherwise also you should avoid these things. Be careful with your tone or words. Respect people's privacy. Do not overuse the chat box. It should not be like that you are the chatterbox of the class, that student who keeps talking throughout the class. Okay, so that should not. Here you can't speak, maybe you are muted, but faculty will unmute you if there's a query or something. But when you had the face-to-face sessions, you had some students who always keep talking, disturbing the class. So don't be that by overusing the chat box. You must respect others' opinion. We all are grown-up individuals, adults. We all can have our opinions, and we must respect each other's. Do not make fun of someone in online chat. Post things that will inspire and motivate people in a positive manner. Don't start rumors or spread gossip about someone online. You must wear proper attire while attending the sessions. So these are the things we expect from you when you are attending the online learning sessions. And with this, I come to the end of today's orientation session. I hope that by now you have a lot of clarity towards the road ahead, that how you're going to have the things, classes, what are the assessments. But of course, still there will be many queries which you would like to ask, which you want to know, many things maybe. So we have the chat box open. You can type in your query and Dr. Nidhi will respond back to you. Okay. Still, if you have something, please reach out to us. Take a little effort, give us a call, post a query, or send us an email on support@imtcdl.ac.in, right? And always remember that success is dependent on effort. So it's very, very, very important that we put efforts in the right direction. We are here to guide you. We are here to help you so that with whatever objective you have enrolled for this program, okay, we are able to uplift your career. I hope the program, PGDM adds on value to your resume, to you as an individual, and shape your personality. We groom you up. Okay. So with an assurance that the learning will ensure that the learning experience that you have over here is wonderful, and you're successfully completing your program, doing great in your career. And on behalf of entire IMT CDL family, I once again congratulate you and welcome you and thank you for attending today's session. So please raise your queries. Thank you so much.